from October onwards, I think November basically, more November than October. Then there were more things were happening, and Sagat Singh has started moving religiously. He was all along. He moved his headquarters to Thalimara. Sagat Singh decided we're going to take over Sylhet. So 7th morning we were told to go to Kailashur. March, as you know, Mujibur Rahman declared independence of Bangladesh and all hell broke loose in Bangladesh. And we were occasionally going to the border, sometimes going inside the border, because FOCO was involved in skirmishes every now and then. And there is, I think Sagat Singh must have started moving towards the border, you know. But occasionally we went and later, especially in October, November time, we started picking up an odd patient here and there, you know, somebody got injured, somebody. But before that, once the Mujibur Rahman declared everything, all hell laws broke, a lot of the refugees started coming into India. And so we knew something was afoot. And of course, Indira Gandhi was already making noises. We must have war. And Manekshaw was already in the press and everywhere. And they wanted war in April, you know. Luckily, Manekshaw said, this is not the time because the monsoons are coming. And it's good to wait till the monsoons are finished. And also, they then started adding in factor of China. If we wait till winter, the Chinese border will be closed. So they cannot come. Otherwise, China was another factor, you know. So that's why the war kept getting delayed, per se. But in a way, it's a good thing because we started preparing for it. You know, we had enough time to prepare for it. And army was all around the border, looking after refugees, getting Mukti Bahinis prepared. And we were told to do a lot of low flying and night landings and unprepared helipads. And so that's what we were doing, myself, my CO, and Flight Lieutenant Jairaman, who was the other flight commander. So three of us were very, very busy doing low flying and training all the pilots. From October onwards, I think November, basically, more November than October. Then they were, more things were happening, and Sagat Singh has started moving religiously. He was all along. He moved his headquarters to Thalimara, you know. So we used to go to Thalimara regularly, you know, help, with any instructions army had. And in his wisdom, which I think was fantastic, Sagat Singh had requested air headquarters and Eastern Air Command to attach one helicopter unit to his core. So 110HU became part of FOCO. So the advantage of that was that he could give us directly, or give the orders directly, rather than going to Eastern Air Command and Eastern Air Command coming to us and then we going and delivering the whatever he needed. So it would take time. But here he could just tell us, he could ring up Sandhu or he could ring me up if I was around, not him personally, but his subordinates. And that was the fantastic thing he did. We were in Kumbigram, 3rd of December, when the war officially got declared. And we were told to disperse the helicopters because savers might come to Kumbigram. So we sent some to IJIL and some other places. And some of them are at Thalimara, three or four were at Thalimara. And our main job those first few days was casualty evacuations and supply of arms and ammunition and any equipment army needed. And of course, troops if they wanted to go somewhere. And communication flights if a general wanted to go somewhere or brigadier wanted to go somewhere. We'll go along and do the work for them. I was still in Kumbigram. We had just sent some aircraft, some of the helicopters to Thalimara. So I hadn't gone with the first lot. Sqn Sandhu had gone with the first lot. He told me you man the base for the beginning. So first three days I was still in Kumbigram. All the helicopters were asked to come to Agartala area. There was a place called Akura just across the border, yes. Pakistan side. They were bombing Agartala all the time, so we couldn't operate from Agartala. So first thing Sagat Singh did was send army there and take over Akura. So once we had Akura, I think around the 5th or 6th of December, Agartala was with us, the airport. So that's where we moved, all the helicopters moved to Agartala. We made that as our base. I went there on the 6th, 5th I think. I left Kumbigram around the 6th. So then I took over because I was the flight commander, I was the ops manager of the squadron. And all this time, we were doing casualty evacuation, communication flights, supply of arms, ammunition, everything. And it was a big area, nearly 500 kilometers, you know, the area SagatSingh was looking after. So when I got there at 6th, of course, I joined the group. And then SagatSingh asked that on the 6th, SagatSingh decided we're going to take over Silat. So 7th morning, we were told to go to Kailashur. So we left 3 helicopters. We had 8 of our unit. So we left 3 helicopters at Agartala for casualty evacuation, communication flight, because that is a very important part of the war. And we took 5 to Kailashur. In the meantime, he had told Eastern Air Command through Chandan Singh to get more helicopters. So we had 4 helicopters sent to us from Chabua, 105 HU. And 3 of them came to Kailashur and 1 came to Agartala. So we had 8 at Kailashur. And we were in Kailashur on 7th morning, about 9-ish. And Brigadier Quinn and Chandan Singh came and took Sandhu and they showed where they wanted us to operate from. We picked a place called Kalora, which is just inside East Pakistan, about 10 minutes away from us or from Kailashur. And then the helipad we picked at Silat was about 15-20 kilometers from the town, so that is out of some small arm fire. So Sandhu and Chandan Singh and the Brigadier had gone and wrecked the place. And we've been going on 6th as well, but 7th morning is when they were decided. So then they told us midday, 4-5 Gurkhas, they were the people we were going to carry to Silat, are going to be arriving at Kalora about midday. So you get there at midday. So that's what we did. We reached Kalora at midday. And we were sitting there out in the field. Fields had been cut, you know, the crops had been cut. So it was open fields. And 4-5 Gurkhas had been given a day off on the 7th of December, because they had gone through a huge battle, 3 or 4 battles, and they had lost even their 2 IC. They had lost quite a few officers and men. So they were exhausted completely. Colonel Hurulkar was in charge of the 4-5 Gurkhas. And he went there and had a chat with the troops. And he says, come on, guys, we're going to go to Silat. That's the job we got now. So they started getting ready. But they weren't ready at 12 o'clock. So about 2:30, 2:45, they started trickling in. And we had arranged one helicopter to stay for Kazbek, but there's some battle still going on around Kailashur area. So we use 7 helicopters. And I briefed all the pilots that I'll be number 1, then 2nd was number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, up to number 7. And we fill up the helicopter and get airborne and keep a gap of 3-4 minutes between each helicopter. So that at any one time, there'll be only one helicopter at Silat, giving less enemy target to the enemy. And so about 2:45, I was the first one to get airborne. And we had removed the clamshell doors behind the helicopter. That gave us the advantage of the soldiers jumping out and jumping in whenever it was required. So I got airborne and we were flying about 1,000 feet. And then direct line, there was no enemy problems on the way. And as soon as I saw the helipad, I landed, I dropped my load and I got airborne. And the second person went, he did the same. I think it's by the time it is the 5th or the 6th helicopter, Pakistan Army started surrounding the field and they were firing at us. But in the meantime, our soldiers are on the ground and they started spreading out. And, you know, they were making the safe area much bigger than actual helipad. So I came back quickly, picked up an next load. We had fuel for three flights each. Went running back again, dropped my next load. And second time when we went, the amount of bullets that are coming towards us and tracer bullets. If you see a tracer bullet, means there are 4 more bullets behind it. It's lots of bullets, just like in the World War movies, and you see the bullets coming towards you. But, you know, we just kept operating. We didn't think any of those bullets are going to hit me. And, you know, whenever we came back, the engineers would have a quick look and they'll say, oh, there's one hole. They'll patch it up, another hole. But there were no technical problems with the helicopter. So we just kept flying as normal. And for the third round, we had 8 helicopters. You know, by the time we said we can use it now, because no casualties had happened. So we used the 8th one as well. So we did total of 22 flights by now. And we came back, and we shut down and we came back to Kailashur, because the field was at Kailashur. And engineers started patching up and cleaning up and doing the maintenance, refueling. And suddenly one of the engineers came and said, sir, one helicopter has not come back. So I called him up and he said, sir, I'm lost. I don't know where the runway is. So we fired a flare to him. And he was in the next valley. There were tiny valleys there, you know, along the Kailashur airport. So he was in the next valley. He had missed the valley. So he saw the flare. He came over and landed. So that is safe. And now about 6:30, 6:45, we told Group Captain Chandan Singh, that we are ready to go again. And Group Captain Chandan Singh had been in an Alouette overhead watching us when the operation was going on. So if he could see hundreds of bullets, he could see thousands, because he could see the whole lot. So he said, no, we're not going now. It's too dangerous. Helicopters are so low, so slow. Anybody can shoot you down. So it'll be like sitting ducks, you know, anybody can shoot you down. So we won't go. We'll go in the morning. And of course, Brigadier Quinn hit the roof because he was in charge of that operation. And he says, the war doesn't stop just because it is night, you know, and we only dropped 250 of my soldiers there. And so they had a big powwow. And he says, if I send a helicopter and it gets shot down, I lose pilots, I lose the aircraft, I lose the soldiers, what do we gain? So I wasn't there. I just heard all that was commotion that was going on between, because we were all resting. I told all my pilots, go and sleep, because we had no time to sleep. You know, all these days, we were working 24/7. So we very rarely had time to sleep. So anytime I had an opportunity, I would tell the guys, go and sleep, and I'll wake you up when I need you. And so I was probably sleeping as well. And so after about 11-ish at night, he came and told me, Ved, you get one crew ready. We'll send one helicopter and see what happens. If it comes back, we'll send the rest. So I said, I'll go myself. I went to the crew room and asked for a volunteer to come with me. Every one of those 30-odd pilots put their hands up. They all seen the bullets. Everybody should be scared. Group Captain Chandan Singh was sure in his mind that helicopters fly low, they fly slow, anybody can shoot us down. So he was 100% sure I was not coming back. And that evening itself, I have an impression, I got the impression that he'd already sent a citation, because he didn't expect me to be coming back. It was just another bullet coming. It was just like a game for us, you know, or one bullet hole or two bullet holes. And none of our pilots refused a single flight. None of our pilots made any excuse, ki main nahi jaunga, I won't go for this. We'll be right back.